Welcome back, guys. Welcome back. Look who's in the house. And look what he's inflicted on me. Oh, you can't even see this.
Let me go in.
Let's have a look. And his injuries. I've only been around for 2 hours and look at him. Shredded to pieces.
And now I'm going to stick him in the water.
Just to add
insult to injury.
So we fixed up his vapor. There was some issues just with the programming with the phase runner, but that's up and running now. You can go and check the video out on his channel and you'll see my accident.
The little incident. It looks like I've turned into a lawnmower.
And he can finally actually like burn his own tyres out.
Yeah.
Right, let's go paddleboarding.
Let's go.
This is the beast, the utility wagon.
The first utility E-class coupe in existence, I think. maybe that's a stretch, but
it's got a pretty nifty little roof lining going on at the moment. I'll show you in a minute. So this is the car camper, basically. He's converted this into the back of it.
Yeah.
You haven't quite finished yet, have you?
Yeah, not quite. I've got a week to finish it before I go away, so.
So cool.
I should be sponsored by Tulay, shouldn't I, really?
Yeah.
Gear I've got on the roof.
I've always said fuel, but it's not. It's Tulay, is it?
I prefer fuel. Fuel sounds better. Tulay sounds a bit crap. I don't know how you pronounce it. Yeah.
It's cool, though. Got bike.
Stealth black bike rack.
Bike rack. And that as well.
Everything for camping in there. I've got tent, shower, toilet and all that.
Nice. You have to get up there and squat.
You're not taking a poo on the roof, but it's an idea.
If we see you like at the side of the motorway, sitting there on the top of the car.
Having a poo. Rubbish seat.
Move the jock strap. Right, we're here. So we're basically going in there, yeah? Pretty nice place, isn't it?
Lovely.
I didn't even know this was just down the road. Well, I knew there was obviously rivers and stuff, but
now we just need a big floaty device.
Yeah, with a motor on it.
Not with a motor on it.
Not this time.
Right, so that's it. You're going to jump on this?
No.
Yeah.
Here we go. So this is like your Lilo, is it?
Yep, ready?
It's big, isn't it? They're bigger than you think, actually.
Yeah, they're long.
Wicked.
And then... Right, so you've got...
So you get this with it, yeah?
Not with all of them. Some come with, depends how much you spend. If not, you can buy aftermarket ones for about 100 quid on Amazon.
That's pretty cool.
But I recommend getting these.
Yeah, you ain't going to blow it up.
Fuck around like pumping for ages.
Run out of breath.
So you just push in. Pig's ear rolled it. Put in, twist. That's it.
Nice.
So now just turn the car on and press that button that says auto.
Does it run from that power bank? It doesn't, does it?
Not quite. No, it cuts out when it
gets so far.
What you do is press auto, that middle button.
Yeah.
Within 10 seconds, this will look inflated.
Really? So it's quite high power. It's quite high power.
No, because it's the same as hand pumping it. It goes up quick. You'll notice it goes up quite, 10 seconds a bit of exaggeration. But the last bit of getting the last PSI takes about 8 minutes.
Okay.
Pump it up, but you'll see. Oh. I've got it in the wrong hole. I've got one for the... I can feel the air.
Always putting in the wrong hole.
Stick it in the wrong hole.
Here we go.
So now that's pumping up.
Right.
You'll see quite quickly it'll take shape.
Yeah, that's good, isn't it?
I see it.
Yeah, it's going up, isn't it? We're getting the end flipping out. I've got this. I reckon I'll be all right.
I mean, you'll be fine, mate. You'll be doing tricks and all sorts.
What tricks can you do?
I don't know. Handstand,
battling.
Do some yoga. You do headstands.
Oh yeah, DJ set on one of them.
It looks like it's fully taken.
Yes, actually, you would never know that that's like an air inflatable one, would you?
That's only on one PSI.
Is it? So he's got his Insta 360 on the end. You've done some pretty cool videos with this.
I've got some really sick photos and videos, and have that.
It's good.
It's a little bit because of the seawater. It's corroded a bit, and it won't tighten up.
Okay.
So what I'll do is I'll put a bag there to hold it.
Yeah.
This is broken.
Yeah, you were saying about that.
Yeah.
It's knackered, it just won't turn on at all.
It won't turn on.
That's really bad, that. So you've got to send it back to
I've never really liked the doors on these. I've got a feeling they're not fully waterproof because it's never been submerged in water, but I've got a feeling it's been splashed. Maybe it's something else, I don't know.
Yeah, it's weird, isn't it? Does it look like there's any water damage inside it if you open the door open or whatever like that? Salt water will be a killer, but it shouldn't.
It's clean as a whistle, isn't it?
Yeah, isn't it? Yeah, they, sometimes they those doors don't actually like close in, yeah, and it won't charge, will it?
It's not very.
It's not good.
Not very confident closing, is it?
No, it's not.
I had to put my old vlogging case on the GoPro.
Well, I haven't seen that for a while.
Yeah, I haven't used this for ages. This is what I started the YouTube channel on, wasn't it?
Yeah, I remember. Yeah, that'd be alright, wouldn't it? Just to get some shots, isn't it?
Yeah.
To see what it's like.
Be rolling.
Yeah.
So what we'll do is...
They're heading off, look.
Over.
He's got all the gear.
No idea.
And an... He's like... We've just got this inflated.
So excited.
Yeah, the fins aren't in the boot. So don't know where the fins are.
Fins in here.
Yeah.
And if they're not in here, then... Don't know where they are.
But, I mean, you might just go around in circles, but we can still try it.
We can still practice balancing, it just might not go in a direction very well.
This is the thing, I know, like, you know, you haven't forgotten, but it's weird, isn't it? It's like, there's so many things with these hobbies, there's so many things that you kind of, you've got to put together to, you know, get to do it. It's like with the e-bike stuff, isn't it? When we're going to do like an e-bike project, we're like, have we got the soldering on? Have we got the wires? Have we got the connectors? Have we got all the things? Yeah, if you miss like one little thing, then the whole thing's ruined. But no, it shouldn't be. We'll have a go. The biggest weird one for me is how do you get on it without it like pissing off up the river?
Well, you got the ankle straps,
right? Okay. Right. Lift
up.
Get that in.
You're not going to lose it.
He's throwing it that hard, part of the...
Oh, looking cool.
Okay, I see what you mean, yeah, so it just holds it there.
It's not going to go off anywhere, so...
You can just get onto it.
You can come down here, stick that there or whatever.
Might be way less stable. So just basically holding on to this.
Get your knees a little bit wide.
And then you're on.
And then you're on, but obviously... It's not going to be anything like it normally is.
Because of the fin. Seem different.
It's hard to tell on my knees. If I try and stand up, I'll probably be able to tell if it's much different. It does feel a bit wobbly side to side. Feels a bit wobbly that way.
Yeah.
Let's see if it goes. Let me try getting to that boat and back. See, it's just going. It's really swinging side to side.
Each stroke you're doing.
But it's quite still, so you can. You can still get where you want, but normally it's a bit straighter.
Yeah.
So it's kind of like Tokyo Drift Sup Edition.
Yeah.
Drifting. So the paddling in the water kind of gives you a bit of balance because there's a bit of like pressure as it hits the water, so it's almost like a walking stick. I'm trying to get back in. Look now, look. Not too bad, you just drift a little bit side to side.
You can basically do this anywhere, no problem.
Yeah, there's certain rules and regulations. Some places you need a river license. Sometimes you'll get someone come up to you in a high-vis jacket asking what your license is, but it's not normally a big deal.
Not as bad as flying a drone. Cool. Right, I need to go.
Can't believe I got you here doing this, mate. It's reality. Uh-huh. Right, grab the paddle and stick that on the ball somewhere. Preferably just poke the end under the strap a little bit. Just a bit. That's all good. Beautiful scenery, and then we've got a noisy train line, but it's... Oh yeah. Yeah, so basically, sort of just start turning yourself to the right, but you just want your hands and feet out even. So as soon as you feel stable to let go and put your right hand down, bring your knees out, you're leaning hard to one side. Spread your weight out to the middle. Basically, when your knees are a bit wider apart than that. Come back a little bit as well, one of your knees is more forward than the other.
Back.
So bring your right knee back so it's level. You're not straight, look at the lines. There you go.
Better?
Right, so yeah, at that point you pretty let go.
Yeah, I'll push away, I'll just push off the wooden bit.
Ooh, shit.
It does feel a bit wobbly, you'll get used to that. Yeah, I don't know, like...
So yeah, hold one hand lower down. That's it, and then... Yeah. You're going to have to figure out now why she ain't going to be able to get back in. I think you'll be able...
There won't be any like barges or anything.
Yeah, don't go too far, mate. We'll get you back again. I think you'll be all right. Just get a feel for it, mate. That's it. Yeah, you're doing mint. You can even stop for a sec. Just hold the the paddle in front of you, like straight, just get a feel for it. Or even wobble a tiny bit on your knees. Get a feel for the balance.
Yeah, got you.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, so you sort of like...
Like, it used to throw me off loads, like how the water move and the ball to move, but the more you just kind of like sort go with the feeling,
with it kind of thing.
Push yourself off the side a little bit. Just get a feel, wobble a little bit, just so you get a feel of the balance.
Right.
Yeah, it's all right, isn't it? It's probably a lot more wobbly than it would normally be as well without the fins, to be fair, so you're doing well.
I forgot about that.
Yeah, so there is that. A river's perfect though, if you've got no fins, you definitely wouldn't want to go on the sea.
Yeah, because it's like literally got like, no...
Nothing holding it straight.
Or anything like that.
No. Sort of... Very, very still here.
Whoa! That's feel like... It's kind of just that feeling of like underneath you.
I reckon...
Huh?
I reckon if like you came in side on and I sat with my feet holding the end of the board still, you could try standing up holding on to the side. I've never done it that way. But just get a feel for having... Nice, yeah, that back was nice. Look at you with the manoeuvres.
I've done some boating. I've done some, you know, like just normal rowing boat stuff in my time.
Can't believe I got you on a paddleboard, mate. Cool, that is real. And he's on a paddleboard. Yeah,
excellent.
That's wicked. Yeah, I would even try standing. Maybe not even with the paddle. Maybe just put the paddle down.
So
or give me the paddle, I'll try and throw it to you, pass it to you. You'll just kneel down, just do what you was doing, just one behind. So get everything equal. Get your feet apart a little bit.
Oh, yeah.
Hold on to the side. Get your feet apart a little bit. Just bend your knees slightly. Take the other hand off. Just you should be able to feel that movement.
Yeah.
You could even pad from one side to the other just to feel a bit of rock, just so you go with it and you know.
Yeah.
Don't do it too much, but yeah, you're standing, mate. You're balancing. Yeah, mate. I'll take my foot away a little bit for a sec. Balancing, mate.
We're on.
You're fucking...
Ooh.
But when you've got this in your hand as well...
Yeah, probably a bit easier.
Like, literally when you plunge that in the water to push away with it, so you have...
You
have one hand on the top of that. That's why it's long.
You're using that to
put your hand on the top of the paddle.
Like that.
No, on top of it, like over the top of it.
Oh, right, okay.
There you go, that's it.
Is that how you're meant to do it?
Yeah, that's how you're meant to do it.
When you're standing up?
Yeah, so when you push that in the water, it's almost like a walking stick because there's some resistance.
Yeah.
So when you plunge that in the water, like the resistance of the water gives you a little bit of balance.
Yeah, got ya.
But yeah, just let your toes, wiggle your toes a little bit, let your toes feel loose, don't tense up too much.
You sort of like, you feel that.
Yeah, you can feel the wobble, but you kind of get used to it. I mean, it's a bit more wobbly than it normally is.
You can feel that sort of, what's it called? Like the sort of skateboard thing where it's doing your calves.
It is, it's that like, stance, bending your knees a little bit.
Trying to sort of...
I mean, my feet are coming off of it now, so...
I don't want
to
do that.
Come down to your knees then. Come down to your knees. I don't even think my knees are actually on it, just on my feet. It was just because I said it, you started panicking.
I
honestly don't think my feet were on it, you was doing it.
Oh, no.
Because I said it, you freaked out. It was fucking hilarious.
No, I don't want to do that. I'm not so comfortable like this for the moment.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Yeah, have a little paddle around, get a feel for like the wobble, the ball moving side to side. Just bear in mind it'd normally be a little bit straighter, you know. Look at him go. He looks so tense. hold your lower hand lower down on the paddle. It looks a bit... Yeah, that's it.
And then what did you do? You've got to swing it around like that?
Yeah. Come a bit upright, a little bit straighter with your back. Just a little bit. That's it. There, you look a lot more comfortable now.
Pro.
Yeah, you look pro now. Yeah, I definitely think you're needing a sec to try stand up again, even if it's at the side like you were, because I wasn't even holding you. You was doing it. I like to have my feet just touching the board a bit, but...
I'll try it in the middle.
In the middle? What, the middle, middle of the river?
Yeah.
Sorry? Boat's coming through. No problem, we'll move out of the way. Thank you.
I'm not worried about
that. Yeah, no, that's fine.
Yeah.
You're glad you told us, Ollie. It was a bit extreme, wasn't it? Get a black eye offering us a life jacket. What's she trying to say? Do I look like a hooligan?
Hooligan.
So what I do is I reverse back a bit of my knees. So if I stand up, I'll be level with the handle. See where the handle is in relation to you. So if you shuffle backwards a bit, get your knees forward, yeah, make sure your knees are not really on the blue bit in the middle. Then stand up into a low, sort of get up like this, slowly get up and slowly balance.
With the paddle
like just halfway across. And then just come back down to your knees. I've never fallen in, even though I've sucked at it. Really? If you just push yourself away from the edge, get the paddle halfway across the board. Well, you don't have to stand up, do you? So push yourself away, you can always get back in on your knees. You've always got that.
Yeah,
it's only a river. You could probably stand up in it if you fell in and dry off. It's not an issue.
Kind of,
so put it flat on the board. That's it. So you're that position. Then from there, step up onto 1 foot. Not too close in. Don't overthink the balance. You already know what it feels like. Just keeping things steady and balanced. So if it rocks, just balance. Don't bring your foot into the middle. Keep it out a little bit.
Is that in there?
You put it on your hands. Put the balance on your shoulders. Just come up into a crouching position. That's it. Just hold that. Now just relax. Hold that. Relax. Slowly grab the paddle so your knuckles are in the board. Slowly. Just wiggle your toes. Make sure your toes are a bit loose. If you need to, you can come down into the kneeling position at any time. You're doing it, mate. Just balance like that. You'll feel better with your hand on the end of the paddle. Right on the end of the paddle, mate. Put your hand over to the end. That's it. You got some serious balance going on now, mate. You might want to straighten a little bit of the bend out of your knee because you'll probably start to burn your leg muscles. Just a little bit. Like you're trying to dig your way out of a trench almost. So punch that arm forwards a bit more. Yeah, you want to switch hands when you switch sides. Drift mode. Mate, done good. Go on, get out of there. Your confidence seems better already.
Yeah.
You're getting to grips. Yeah.
Once that kind of goes, you know what to expect.
You're getting a feel for turning, you're getting a feel for the balance more. You're looking more confident on it.
Going for a cruise. Oh. That's me, like, trying to. Right. So guys, that is my first go at paddleboarding. I think I'm definitely going to be investing in a board so we can do more stuff together.
Nice.
Like this. It's just so chill. I mean, what's not to like? Just amazing. I've always thought that. I always liked the river and I always like riding my e-bike down the river as well. So I think, you know, it's just one step further. Let's go in the river.
It's a different vibe being on the water. It just really is. It's
wicked.
Just something about it. It's relaxing. We were just
really good.
We were just talking about it. I don't know, it's hard to explain. It's just something about being on the water and it's sort of being in nature really, isn't it?
I thought it would actually be easier than that. I thought I was going to get on and be like, yeah, that's all right. But there is quite a lot of kind of stuff to learn because you're just not really expecting what's going to happen.
Posture,
I think once you learn what, you know, it's like muscle memory, sort of anything, isn't it?
Even in that, you got more confident in
having a go.
In a space of like 10, 20 minutes, you were way more confident than when you first got on by the end.
So
it's giving you a feel for it now.
Yeah, thanks for
that. That's all right. I have to get some fins on it. That's the other thing as well. It had no fins, absolutely no fins on it. So it's not ideal. It's just going around in circles like Tokyo Drift. So which is fun, but it's probably not ideal for learning.
Anyway, guys, go out, try something new, try paddleboarding if you haven't already. Catch you in the next video.